The public who hears the word, the Quran, what comes to mind? Book of violence, terrorism, submission of women, degradation of women's right, hate for other faiths, satanic verses, the quote-unquote Sharia law. What comes to mind? These are the things that the media promotes and it propagates on an insistent basis. It is not only that it's continual, not only that it's continuous, that it's insistent. It is non-stop. It is 24 hours that they are harping and carping on the same points of Sharia law, book of violence, and Islamophobes like Pamela Geller saying that the last chapter of the Quran is the most violent chapter has no basis whatsoever in the Quran or in Islam. Islam hating has become an industry. It has become actually not only a cottage industry, it has actually become an industry. People are making millions and millions of dollars based on hate. So what's in the Quran? You should ask for yourself. Aristotle said that the sign of an intelligent person is that they entertain the thought, not necessarily that they have to accept it. So we pride ourselves in North America to be so enlightened, but yet we don't want to entertain the thought to see what's in it. Why do you curse the Quran? Why do you curse Islam? Why do you actually set up these Islamophobes all over the place in order to just give them monies for this big boogeyman that's out there? Things that you will find in the Quran that you could have never imagined. Number one, do not lie. وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ, that stay away from false witnessing, meaning get away from lying. Allah does not love the liars, meaning to say that you have to be a truthful person. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to be truthful, that if you are truthful, you will become truthful in the sight of God until He enters you into paradise. Is that not a good thing? Is that not a wonderful teaching? Secondly, the Quran teaches us not to spy. Not to spy. وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا. Do not spy. Spying has actually become a billion-dollar industry. AI, artificial intelligence, to see job satisfaction. They look at facial recognition to see if the job is satisfying the individual. Your post on this great Facebook from Mr. Zuckerberg, that to detect depression. To see if you are having any ailments, to check your heart rate through webcams. It comes to you like that. This causes stress for the human being continuously being watched. And it's going to get worse and worse as the days go on. There's a study that shows rats, and I will just make it very, very succinct, that there were mice in a cage, but a predator was next to the mice. Although the mice were safe in a glass box, they were still stressed because they were being watched by the predator. And that's exactly how the human beings are always stressed and under pressure, being watched by the unknown predator. Thirdly, the Quran states not to ridicule, not to ridicule. Is that not a good thing? Do not lie, do not spy, do not ridicule. Did you ever open the Quran and see what a wonderful thing that is? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّن قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, do not belittle a people that they may be better than them. Meaning to say, ridicule is actually disallowed in the religion of Islam, and it's a commandment from the Quran. So all this ridicule, calling sisters raghead and brothers who wear kufis, you know, these towel wearers and all kinds of pejorative names, these are not our statements. The Quran actually says, when the ignorant speak, tell them salam, meaning to say peace, and you keep moving on, because barking dogs will bark only. So ridicule leads to arrogance, leads to hate, leads to contempt. And after a while, when you keep ridiculing, because even in Rwanda, when they started calling each other cockroaches, it's much easier to kill a cockroach than to kill a human being. So it starts off by naming. That's what Hitler did. That's what all of these dictators do. They start calling names and labeling. So ridicule is the start to arrogance, to hate, to contempt. The victims actually feel low self-esteem, lack of worth. That's what happens to the victim. Fourthly, the Quran teaches, do not waste. وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not waste, for Allah does not love the wasters. Half of the world is under the poverty line. And our green bins, our compost bins, are brimming with leftover food. There's something wrong with this picture. So the Quran is actually a guidance in that. Do not waste. Why are we wasting? Is that not a good thing? This is how the Quran teaches. Fifth, that do not be unkind to parents. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا That at old age homes that are filled with children that have abandoned their parents. They don't go to visit them. The parents just languish away in old age homes and die of depression. That's what happens. Although the old age homes like to make you think that, oh, they're living in a sanctuary. But people need their families at the end of the day. So the Quran said, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا That not to only be just kind to the parents, but to be excellent. Six, do not do shameful deeds. The Quran, open it. That's what it says. It has nothing to do with terrorism. It says, do not do shameful deeds. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنْ That in chapter 6, verse 151, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that do not come close to indecency from inside or out, meaning to say from any which way, from every angle, stay away from indecency and things that actually lead to indecency. That's a great thing because the society has become totally plagued with indecency. Now you have clothing that have no cloth. Now you have shirts that have holes in them. So the idea here is that decency is extremely important. Now they're promulgating and they're promoting shows that actually to have no shame, and people have no shame, and that's killing us as a society. The Quran teaches us to pray. The Quran tells us to pray. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ Is that not a good thing? In the age of non-prayer, in the age of distraction, in the age of being overdosed with drugs and being intoxicated with alcohol and marijuana and you name it. Is that not a good thing in a day and an age, in a cusp where we're going to fall off the precipice and into a deep chasm where we can find that it's a time for prayer and contemplation? Is that not a good thing? That's what's in the Quran. That's what the Quran states. Eighthly, that the Quran says that do charity and do good deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّن خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, establish the prayer and give the zakah, and whatever you send forward from yourselves of good things, you will find it with the Almighty. You will find it with the Almighty. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty knows exactly what you do. Knows exactly what you do. The ninth point here, brothers and sisters, is that to be just always. The Quran says to be just always. So if somebody wants to know what's in the Quran is actually saying to be just always. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَشُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Oh you who believe, be a just nation and be witness unto the Almighty, even amongst yourself. أَوِلْ وَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ And even against your parents and your close kith and kin. Whether one is rich or poor, Allah is worthy of both. So follow not the personal inclination, lest that you not be just. And if you distort, meaning your testimony, or refuse to give it, then indeed Allah is ever acquainted with what you do. What could be more sublime? What could be more elevated than this? This is justice. Justice is not for the rich people. Justice is not for these propped up dictators. Justice is not for dropping bombs on innocent human beings. Justice is not for terrorizing civilians. Justice is not for invading defenseless countries. This is justice, that you be just, that you be a just nation, that you actually show that even against yourselves, even against your parents, even, that's a hard thing. Who can go against their parents? But Islam, the Quran, the primary text of Islam, tells us that we must be just even to that point. Because if your sister has done something, and if you do not give the right testimony, somebody who is innocent and has not done anything will languish in jails, just like in these countries, that people, innocent people, languish in jails because somebody else gets away because they have high-priced lawyers. And that's why Islam is a way forward for justice. The last point, brothers and sisters, is that the Quran states emphatically not to be a racist. The Quran eschews all ideas of racism. The Muslims are told to jettison racism, not to have even a modicum of it in their heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, O mankind, we have created you from a male and female and made you people and tribes, that you may get to know one another. Indeed, inna akramakum indallahi atqakum, indeed, the most noble of you in the sight of Allah is the most God-conscious of you, the most righteous of you. The people who are God-conscious, they are the ones who are the first in the sight of Allah. Not the fattest of you, not the thinnest of you, not the blackest of you, not the whitest of you, not the richest of you, not the poorest of you, but the one who is most righteous and most God-conscious. That is important. Racism inflicts a terrible damage on the victim. The whole society is damaged with it. It does not function properly. The society does not function. So the Quran is sublime. So brothers and sisters, and anyone out there listening, should know that racism is not something that we should actually imbibe in any form. And look into the Quran. So if you think next time when they say, oh well, the Quran, the last chapter is the most violent chapter, well, see it for yourself. Open the Quran and read it in context. Because if I were to read some of the other scriptures of different religions out of context, it would be totally a fiasco. And it would be unjust for me to do so. So understand that. So anybody that actually wants to look into the Quran, look into it and see what the Quran says, rather than making up your mind by listening to shallow people that are in the media. Make up your mind by opening the Quran, asking knowledgeable people in Islam, and visiting a Muslim next to you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on all of us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.